to music today. Hello, third grade. Hello, third grade. Hello, third grade, and welcome to music today. Hey there, third grade. It's good to see you. Thank you for joining me today. Let's sing hello to our friends near and far. And in fact, if you want to think of a specific friend that you want to sing to, let's go ahead and add them into our song. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. And welcome to music today. And what about hello to our family? Hello to Mr. Houchin, please. Hello, Mr. Houchin. Hello, Mr. Houchin. Hello, Mr. Houchin, and welcome to music today. And one more time, hello to everyone. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone, and welcome to music today. Third grade, and welcome to another digital music class with me, Mr. Houchin. It's good to see you all again. Thank you for spending the time and joining me here. Hope you're ready to sing, hope you're ready to move, hope you're ready to have some fun and do some music with me right now. In fact, let's take a look at what we're going to do today. Got lots in store. We've got our hello song, our warm-up, continuing with our Springs message and Little Liza Jane from last time, and then we're going to throw it back with Wayfaring Stranger, Amazing Grace, and even a throwback with our musician of the month before we sing goodbye. Now, my goals for you today are pretty simple. First one, with our Springs message, sing a song in three and really get a feeling for that three beat in there. Last week, we sort of decoded the rhythm from part of it. This week, we're just worried about making sure we're feeling that three pattern in there. With Little Liza Jane, we're going to identify and compare some melodic fragments. Ooh, what does that mean? And then I think with the rest of our time, I just want to sing some old favorites that I know you guys love to sing. And, you know, it's the end of the year, so let's dust off some of our favorites from the year. But first, as always, let's warm up real quick. And let's start with our little shaking it up warm up. So, we're going to shake our hands five times each, shake our feet five times each, and count down five times, four times, three times, two times, one time, until we're shaking our whole body all at once. So pick your favorite hand, hold it up, get ready to shake, and one, two, three, four, five. Other hand, two, three, four. Shake your foot, two, three, four, five. Other foot, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Other foot, two, three, four. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two. One, two. One, two. One, two. One, 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 one. Nice job, nice job. Go ahead and take a nice big yawn for me. I'm so tired. And how about this yawn off of a really high voice this time? Go. I'm so tired. Beautiful, beautiful. And let's warm up with our fun little warm-up that we've been doing the past week or so. Our Dwee-a-Bobaloo. Can you say it really fast and really clearly? And use your best singing voice. Ready. Dwee-a-Bobaloo, 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 Bobaloo, Dwee. Dwee-a-Bobaloo, 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 Bobaloo, Dwee. A little bit higher. Dwee-a-Bobaloo, 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 Bobaloo, Dwee. Nice job, nice job, nice job. Good for you. Take a deep breath and sigh. And how about a slow breath in through your nose, out through your mouth. Slower and quieter, please. Fantastic. Really nice work. Thank you very much. Okay. So let's start with our first song today, and that is our Spring's Message. And last week we sort of looked at the cuckoos and decided, you know, which one was a ta-ta rest and which one was tu-ta, and kind of dissected the rhythms that make them up. This week what I'd like to do is just focus on our singing and focus on finding some creative ways to keep a beat with this song. So just as a review, can you sing with me, starting with cuckoo? Ready? Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Now let us sing and dance and be merry. Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Come to the field, so pleasant to see. For springtime comes merrily. Just like that. So I thought of a really fun way for us to try to keep the beat with this. Now, we've been doing a lot of beats with three where we have a big and two littles. Today, I'm going to sort of change that up. And the beat that I want you to try first goes pat, clap, snap. And you put that on a loop like this. Pat, clap. One, two, three. One, two, three. Now, if you can't snap, remember, you can just tap your fingers really lightly at the top to sort of give us that feel. But we're going from the bottom up. Pat, clap, snap, pat. Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Now let us sing and dance and be merry. Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Just like that. Now what I'd like you to do is take a moment to think. You can even pause the video and come up with your own three beat pattern that you can put on a loop like that. Now you can do something simple where you're doing a big beat and two little beats, or you're doing three separate beats, but try to have at least two things going on. If you're not quite sure on what you can do the beat that I'm doing, or you can think of one of our simple big little beats that we've done before. All right, so take a moment, decide what you want to do, pause if you need to, and we're going to start again, and we'll do the second verse this time. I'm going to keep doing the pat, clap, snap. So here's my beat. One, two, three, one. Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Come to the field, so pleasant to see. For springtime comes merrily. Nice job. Excellent work. We're going to go back and do the first verse one last time and decide if you want to keep your beat or if you want to change it to something new. You can keep your beat, change it to something new, or do the beat with me. Okay? Take a second to decide. Good to go. And let's try the first verse one last time with your new beat. Ready? One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two. Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Now let us sing and dance and be merry. Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Nice work. All right, let's move on to something new that we learned last time with our little Liza Jane. Like this. I got a house in Baltimore, little Liza Jane. Streetcar runs right by my door, little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, little Liza Jane. Repeat after me. I got a house in Baltimore. I got a house in Baltimore, little Liza Jane. Eliza, little Eliza Jane, little Eliza Jane. Oh, Eliza, oh, Eliza, little Eliza Jane, little Eliza Jane. Can you sing this first verse with me? Here we go. I got a house in Baltimore, little Eliza Jane. Streetcar runs right by my door, little Eliza Jane. Oh, Eliza, little Eliza Jane. Oh, Eliza, little Eliza Jane. Great work, great singing. Now, last week we took a look at the little Eliza Jane part. And we kind of discovered by looking at the colors and listening to the song that each time we sing it, it sort of is a little bit different. And when we sing it with the yellow words, it sounds different than when we sing it with the pink words. And today what I want to do is I want to actually figure out what the melody is. What are the pitches that we're singing using do, re, mi, so, and la? So let's just do a quick review. Repeat after me. Do, do, do. Do, do, do. Do, re, mi. Do, re, mi. Mi, so, mi, mi, so, mi, mi, so, la, mi, so, la, la, so, mi, re, do, 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 la, so, mi, re, do, 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 do. Beautiful. We spent a lot of time at the beginning of these digital classes and a lot of time in class sort of reading and singing this, so this should be a little easy. So what I'm going to show you now is first the yellow version of Little Eliza Jane, and I've given you a staff up here. And I've told you where do is, and I've told you where so is. Right now what you need to be thinking about, if I know where do is, I know where so is, where would I put la, where would I put mi, and where would I put re? Now remember, sometimes we have notes that are on the line, and that means the line actually goes through the middle of it, so they go through the middle of the line. Or we have notes that are on the space, which means they actually exist in between the space of the lines. If you look up here, we notice the first part, little, is on the line above what I have marked as so. Li is in the space that's marked so. Za is in the space that's marked below so and in the space that's marked above do. And Jane is back on the space marked so. So, if we were to sing, little Eliza Jane. Sing that for me. Little Eliza Jane. We could sing it on no words. We go ba 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 ba. If we were to take our do re mi fa sol la ti do, all that sort of stuff, and put it on here, what would we get? Now that first part, little, it's on the line above so. So we're gonna know that that is la. Li is on the space that has so on it, so we know that that is so. And we drop down a space to z. It's above do, but it's not the line above, it's the space above. So we're gonna say that that is mi, and then Jane back on so. So the first little Eliza Jane in yellow is la, so, mi, so. So, I've got a house in Baltimore. La, so, mi, so. Streetcar runs right by my door. The next little Eliza Jane is different. Little Eliza Jane. It's a little bit lower. So let's take a look at our other little Eliza Jane. Notice this one starts on mi. Little Li is on mi. Take a look at za. What do you think it's on? And Jane, where do you think they go? Bum, 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 bum. Bum, bum, bum. How about you sing what you think the answer is? So I'll go, a streetcar runs right by my door. Bum, 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 bum. All right. Well, what I see written up here is mi, mi, re, do. The za is on the line for re, and Jane is on the space for do, and little I's on the space for me. So we have mi, mi, re, do. So if I were to sing these in the context of the song using our solfege, our song starts to sound like this. I got a house in Baltimore, la, so, mi, so. Streetcar runs right by my door, mi, mi, re, do. Can you try that with me? Reading the music up there, singing the solfege, not the words. I gotta have some Baltimore, la so mi so. Streetcar runs right by my door, mi mi re do. It works for the next part too. Oh, Eliza, la so mi so. Oh, Eliza, mi mi re do. We always do the yellow one first and the pink one after that. All right, see if you can remember those patterns, la so mi so. And mi mi re do. And let's go back and do the second verse of our song. And instead of singing Little Liza Jane, can you sing the solfege if you can? Well, come my friend and be with me, la so mi so. I will take good care of thee, mi mi re do. Oh, Eliza, la so mi so. Oh, Eliza. Nice job. Let's try the song one more time, this verse, but we'll do the words this time. So back to what you see on the screen. Come, my friend, and be with me, little Liza Jane. I will take good care of thee, little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, little Liza Jane. Fantastic. Great work, everybody. Nice job. Great job using your music reading skills, your solfege skills, and your beautiful singing voices. Nice work. All right. Well, I'd like to spend the rest of class kind of throwing it back to some things that we did earlier this year. And I want to throw it back to a song that we did for the winter concert. That was a really amazing performance because not only did it feature us singing, but it featured some of you playing ukulele. So if you have your ukulele and you know how to play this, you can go grab it and play it along with me right now. Pause the video so you have time to go do that. But let's just do Wayfaring Stranger a couple times, all right? And how about we start with a little humming to kind of remind us how the melody goes. Start kind of low in our voice, but then we're gonna get nice and high. I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger, a traveling through this world of woe. But there's no sickness, toil, nor danger in that bright land to which I go. I'm going home to see my father. I'm going home. Just a poor wayfaring stranger, a traveling through this world of woe. But there's no sickness, toil, nor danger in that bright land to which I go. I'm going home to see my father. I'm going home, no more to roam. Just a going over Jordan, I'm just a going over home. Fantastic. Alright. What a lovely song. And I just remember when you guys sang that and performed that. Beautiful. Well, this kind of reminds me of another song that we also did this year that was another beautiful song for us to sing. And that was Amazing Grace. Now, I'm sure you're aware of some things that have been going on in the world today and seeing stuff on the news. And one of the reasons I wanted to sing this song today is because it is one of those songs that sort of can instill in us a feeling of hope and a feeling of sort of calm and that, you know, maybe things are going to be okay. And so I encourage you, if this song helps you, if this song makes you feel a little bit better, to, you know, remember it and to sing it and, you know, sing it with your family. And yeah, so let's try this one together. And remember, this one does get a little high in our voice, so just don't scream it out. Think about singing lightly up in our high voice as we talk about class. Amazing praise, how sweet the sound that saved a soul like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already His grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a soul like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. All right, let's take a moment now to talk not about our Musician of the Month for the month of June, because, well, frankly, we usually don't have a Musician of the Month in the month of June, because school is sort of close to an end, and we usually have performances going on and end-of-the-year activities. It's sort of hard to fit in a new Musician of the Month and give them the time they deserve. So instead, I thought we'd throw it back to one of our previous Musicians of the Month. Now, you might remember this musician from the beginning of the year. Her name is Rhiannon Giddens, and she is a folk singer. She plays the banjo, the violin, she sings, and she was actually the inspiration for us for that song, Wayfaring Stranger. So I thought I'd share her version of that song again today, just so we can kind of relive it and sort of remember, you know, what a beautiful performance it was. And so here's Rhiannon Giddens performing Wayfaring.
Traveling through this world alone, there is no sickness, toil, or danger in that fair land to which I go. I'm going home to see my mother. Home to see my mother.
Just an incredible performance by an incredible musician. All right, third grade, that's it for today's music class. Now, next week, we're going to be doing music a little different. We won't have our normal kindergarten, first grade, second grade, third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade digital music classes. Instead, I'm going to be doing some live music classes for you. So keep an eye out in your Google Classrooms and information from your parents on how exactly that's going to work and how you can access that. And hopefully we'll be able to see each other and sing some of our favorite songs and make some music together. Until then, be well, stay safe, and goodbye. Goodbye, third grade. Goodbye, third grade. Goodbye, third grade. And thank you for music today. Goodbye, and be well.